makes them the cutest thing in the world.
Landings turtles are so cool. They've got this bright yellow chin. They kind of look like an army helmet with this dome shape of their shell. They are just incredible. Incredible to watch.
59 by 51.
They're so cool. They are one of the longer lived species that we have in Iowa as far as turtles go. They can live 80 to 90 years.
The turtles in this area kind of took a hit a little over a decade ago. We had a really late snowstorm in late April, early May, and the turtles didn't survive. We applied for a competitive federal grant with our partners, Blank Park Zoo and Iowa State University, and we got that grant. And so we're trying to get the population back up.
Ready to go.
So we have pretty high mortality rates of adult turtles across the Midwest, just because of the fact that the wetlands that they reside in are pretty fragmented.
These are the ones.
So they're really susceptible to being hit or crushed on a road or by heavy machinery.
248B.
We needed someone who knew how to raise turtles, how to incubate the eggs and hatch the eggs, and the zoo is a perfect partner to do that.
And getting them hatched is the first hurdle. So when they're out in the wild and they're an egg, there's no protection. So foxes or coyotes or raccoons, anything can get them. If they're in a farm field, they can get run over.
And we're gonna be placing it on their inner side scoot right here. These are transmitters that we're going to be putting on the little turtles. They last for about 2 months. And we go out into the wetlands and they emit a beep and have a specific radio frequency that we can turn to.
With this data, we're mostly looking at survival, so seeing how well these head started turtles survive post-release, but we're also going to be looking into movement, so how they're moving post-release.
We are releasing some young juvenile Blandings turtles today.
Six here, like four or five here, like three or four here.
We have been planning this for many, many years, and it took a while to get the federal funding lined up. We've been doing the habitat work on public lands for a long time. We needed private landowners who were also willing to do habitat work.
There we go.
It really is a community effort to get this work done.
We all get to have this small little impact, and hopefully it'll make a huge big impact for a population that needs help.
And it's been super rewarding to help these guys thrive. The slimy, scaly guys, like amphibians and reptiles, don't get enough love and aren't really known. So this is a really unique project.
If you have the chance to see Blandings turtles, either at a zoo or in the wild, be sure you have your camera. They are just absolutely gorgeous animals.